It's the Middle Ages and you feel like venting some of your frustrations. In those days, there were no such things as social media pages or YouTube comments boxes. So what a person might have done is take a knife and etched their anger into the side of a wooden building. They might have written something like, "Down with the King," or "Satan is my savior," and for that bit of serious vandalism, they would have been in big trouble if it was discovered they were the author of those shocking words. A suitable punishment might have well been coffin torture, and you'll soon see why this was one of the worst punishments ever. Okay, so firstly, we are not talking about premature burial, aka being buried alive. That nasty practice has also been used as a method of execution throughout the ages, but it's not the topic of today's show. We're also not talking about immurement, or what is sometimes called being walled up or walled in. We've been there and done that. Coffin torture at first sight might not look anywhere near as bad as being walled in, but as you shall see, that all depends on how it was done. So let's say you lived in that period called the Middle Ages. That's a pretty long stretch of time, since the period spans from the 5th century to the 15th century. Maybe in, 1456, a man did indeed vandalize a public building with the words that could be said to be a threat to national security or construed as blasphemy. Maybe a public crime should result in a public punishment. This is where coffin torture comes in. In some cases, this might consist of a person being confined to a very small metal or wooden cage, and that cage was then strung up to a structure we sometimes called a gibbet. He also could have just been strung up to a tree. So a person might have been put in something that looked like a birdcage and then strung up in the air. That cage might have also been something much more uncomfortable. Something that looked like a cage fitted around the human body, like a cage suit. That suit was what you might call tight-fitting, and being hugged by metal is rather more painful than being hugged by expensive soft fabric. So let's say you were the person who wrote those terrible messages left for the public to see. In those days, saying that kind of thing would have offended a lot of people. They wouldn't have just said some bad things about you or blocked you from their yard, and there was no doxing back then, so the masses of the town might have turned up to see you hanging in your cage. This is where it can get really bad. You see, the angry mob might have come armed with rocks or even wooden spears, and you would have been target practice. After a few hours of being pelted by rocks and sharp objects, the person in the coffin would either have been seriously injured or even dead. This might not have happened, though, and let's say that an order had been issued to the public that they should not throw things at the person. That's because there's another kind of torture called exposure. We can tell you that if you were merely dressed in rags or even left naked, a couple of days hanging in a cage in a European winter would have been brutal, if not deadly. A hot summer wouldn't have been very nice either. Some sources tell us that the person would just be left there to die, notwithstanding the weather. It only takes about 3 days without water to kill a person. The dead man or woman might have been left up there while ravenous birds and insects make a meal out of their corpse. Rats are also pretty good at climbing trees, and there were always plenty of them around in the old days. And by God, we can tell you that blasphemy back in the past was one serious crime, as was stating that you weren't that keen on the king. People's freedom of speech, you might say, was somewhat limited. We can imagine at some point in your life you've written something online that could have gotten you killed a few hundred years ago. As for real-life cases, there is the story of the highwayman named John Whitfield, who it said kept part of the English countryside in a state of terror. His death sentence was being chained up and hung from a gibbet. The St. James Chronicle states that this happened on August 12, 1768, and he was just left there to die. One of the most famous pictures of someone strapped inside of a coffin is that of a Scottish man named William Kidd. He was a pirate hunter, but he was said to be something of a savage himself. The authorities, after a while, said this man was not just a pirate hunter, but a pirate himself. The Parliament of England sentenced him to death in 1701. We should say, though, that he was hanged first and then strung up in a cage just so people could see what happened to wrongdoers. 1701 wasn't the Middle Ages, so we guess the English improved their stance on human rights somewhat. Actually, at the time, gibbeting dead men was a bit of a tourist attraction for people who were visiting London. But the locals complained that it was rather gruesome and the stench of a rotting body was horrible. Imagine today walking over one of those wonderful bridges in London and seeing a putrefying corpse in a cage. Oh, how times have changed. In fact, putting dead bodies on display wrapped up in iron was common all over the world, including in what we now call the USA. The practice happened a few times when the country was still under British rule, although we found one case where this happened to Cuban pirates who were put in cages to rot in New York in 1815. It seems this public display of the dead happened mostly in the 19th and 18th centuries, and the live coffin torture and exposure happened in the centuries before that. So maybe you missed some of our other gruesome punishment videos, so now we'll give you two of them which we think are outstanding. So take a look at one of these, the Catherine Wheel, Worst Punishments in the History of Mankind, or the Brazen Bull, Worst Punishment in the History of Mankind.